Hello friends, as exams of AIIMS, AIPG and DNB are quite near and recently 19th edition of Harrison has come, lot of new things have come up. So now I will be taking a series of lectures so that you all are updated with the recent advances and the new updates in the 19th edition, plus many more things which are relevant in for the upcoming exams. So this is the lecture number one. Today now is this is the lecture number one. About the recent updates in Harrison 19th edition. Recent update in 19th edition. Zoom karein. So let's talk first thing about new updates in diabetes. What has come up in diabetes? So first of all, we talk about new drugs in diabetes. New drugs in diabetes. The first is new drugs. First of all, Colsevalam. Colsevalam. This is a new antidiabetic drug. It is a bile acid sequestrant. It is a bile acid sequestrant. This is a number one drug for diabetes. This is a first new drug for diabetes. Many more are to follow right now. Second drug, bromocriptine. We know it very well. Zoom karenge. We know it very well that bromocriptine is the one drug that we have been using for Parkinson treatment and for the treatment of galactorrhea. But now it has been approved as a anti-diabetic drug also. Now there is one drug, lorcaserin. This is a new drug. It's for treatment of obesity. Treatment of obesity. Because it is a anorexic drug. It is a anorexic drug. And this name is not given even in 19th edition of Harrison also. So this is beyond 19th edition. But this question came in last year exam, in PGI exam. But this is the latest question, but not given in 19th edition also. Similarly, so this drug is not given in 19th edition. Then we have resveratrol. Resveratrol. It's a new drug. It's a new drug. New drug is again anorexic drug. Anorexic drug. So reduces the for treatment of obesity, and now and you know very well, type 2. The basic reason for type 2 is obesity. So if you reduce the body weight, then you are bound to reduce the diabetes status also. So friends, this is the box number one, what you have to remember. This is the box number one. Okay? New drugs for diabetes. Resveratrol, lorcaserin, bromocriptine, and well, we continue more drugs. Now, one more drug which has come, new drug continue, is renal glucose transport inhibitor. Renal glucose transport inhibitor. It has been recently introduced in Indian markets also. The drug is canaflozine. Canaflozine. This came in 19th edition of Harrison. Is there update? Is there? And it is available in the Indian market. It is there. Canaflozine, the new drug. Okay. Next, we talk about. This is the box number two. This is the box number two. Now I would like to highlight one drug, which has been recently been approved. But it has not come in Harrison 19th edition also. So we go beyond 19th edition. The drug is Imaglimin. Imaglimin. It's a new anti-diabetic drug. New, but we not given in 19th edition also. So this is beyond 19th edition. This is the box number 3. Box number 3 for diabetes. Now we have one more drug, Apalristat. This drug is available in Indian market. It's a tablet. Available in Indian market for last 1.5 years. But, and this one drug, it prevents complication of diabetes. But this name is not given in 19th edition also. So one more thing, beyond 19th edition is Apalristat. It is drug. It is used. It is for the treatment, but you can say for the prevention of complication in diabetes because it is a aldose reductase. It's a aldose, zoom karenge, aldose reductase inhibitor. It's a aldose reductase inhibitor, the new drug. Not given 19th edition also. This is the box number 4. This is the box number 4. Right, sir? So right now we got 3 drugs which are not given in 19th edition also. So all are updates. So we talk more about the new drugs. Now, let's talk about some more drugs. We have GIP, GLP-1 agonist drug. We have GIP, GLP-1 agonist drug. They include injection, exenatide, injection, liraglutide. Injection, so we talked about GIP, GLP-1 agonist. And we have DPP-4 inhibitors. DPP-4 inhibitors. Inhibitors. They include tablet sitagliptin. Tablet vildagliptin. Okay. This is the box number 5. This is the box number 5. So we have two categories. One is DPP-4 inhibitors. Other is GIP, GLP-1 agonists. Point to be noted. These two are injections. And these are tablets. This is very important drugs. And you will pakka get one question from this particular box number 5. Then we have amylin agonist. Amylin agonist drug. And this include injection pramlintide. This is the box number 6 to be remembered. Injection pramlintide is amylin agonist. Now we talk about some newer insulin. We have newer insulin ultra short acting insulin. Ultra short acting, that is injection. Ultra short acting insulin injection. Glulisine. Glulisine injection. Aspart. This is the box number 7. Ultra long acting insulin. Ultra long acting insulins. Injection Detemir. Injection Glargine. It is this injection so called peakless insulin. So called peakless insulin. So we have a box number 8. Ultra long acting insulins. Ultra long acting, ultra short acting insulins. Now we got one more drug which has been recently launched in the Indian market and whose name is not given in 19th edition of Harrison also. So we are going beyond 19th edition. Injection Degludec. Injection Degludec. It is a very, very, very long acting insulin. Very long acting insulin. Very long. You may even may give once in 2 days also. Okay. So very long, but this drug is available in Indian market. So these are all new drugs. Latest drugs are there. This is the box number 9. Injection Degludec. Well, there's one more insulin whose name is, so this is beyond Harrison 19th edition. 19th edition beyond. Now there's one more insulin which is not, whose name is not given in 19th edition. The drug is available in USA, but it has not come to Indian market. That is Afreeza. Afreeza. Afreeza is an inhaled insulin. Inhaled insulin. inhaled insulin. This is not in 19th edition also. So these are the drugs which are beyond 19th edition also. Afrezza. Okay? Right, so we got a lot of new information about the new drugs in diabetes. Now let's talk something more about recent advances which have come. Well, we know how we diagnose a case of diabetes. Regarding the diagnosis of diabetes. Diagnosis. The new criteria which has come up to diagnose, that is, if other than the previous one, that fasting more than 126, random more than 200, but new criteria has come. The new criteria is if HbA1c is more than 6.5%, this is one more criteria of diabetes. This is the box number 11. That HbA1c more than 6.5% is diabetes. One more new thing has come up in biochemistry. Estimated average glucose. Estimated average glucose. So this is based on HbA1c. This is HbA1c. So estimated average glucose, what we write in short as EAG. In short, we write as EAG is box number 12. Estimated average glucose is HbA1c. They are the all latest concept. Now let's talk about something. One more thing which is not given in 19th edition also, but widely discussed in all the conferences. So we talk about 50 gene. THRI 50 genes. This is beyond 19th edition. It's not given in 19th edition also, but widely discussed in all the conferences. These genes are responsible for overeating. Overeating, which lead to increased body weight, and that predisposes to type 2 diabetes. So 50 gene is concerned with overeating, widely discussed in the conferences, 50 gene. Okay. Now we have one more thing. Leptin. This question will pakka come to you. Widely discussed in all the conferences. Leptin is a naturally occurring compound which reduces insulin resistance. It's a one compound which reduces insulin resistance. Okay, so obviously if it reduces resistance, the diabetes or sugar will come down, right? So this is a naturally occurring compound in the body which reduces insulin resistance. Box number 14, leptin. Right, now we talk about down and up regulation of receptor. Down and up regulation of receptors. Down and up regulation of receptor. Up. regulation of receptors. Let's learn what is this talk about. Zoom out karenge. Now what happened in type 2 diabetes? You know, obesity is the main reason of diabetes. And number two, in type 2 diabetes, serum insulin level is more than normal. But still the patient is hyperglycemic. Why? Learn the basic. This is the body weight. This is the number of insulin receptor. As the body weight goes up, number of receptor go down. This is known as down regulation of receptor. As the body weight come down, the number of receptor go high, we call as up regulation of receptor. It means what? If in type 2 diabetes, person loses the body weight, the number of receptor go high, already body has sufficient insulin in type 2 diabetes. That's why in type 2 diabetes, the first and the most important thing in the treatment is to reduce the body weight. So friends, down and up regulation of receptor is seen in type 2 diabetes. Type 2 diabetes. This is the box number 15. This is the box number 15. Box number 15. Now we talk about some of the complication of diabetes. So first we talk about cardiovascular disease in diabetes. So we have a term, new thing has come up, recent ones, is legacy effect. Legacy effect. Legacy effect, also known as metabolic memory. Let's learn what is this. Let's learn the thing. Suppose I am sitting in my OPD, a obese man comes, he's diabetic for last 10 years, and I say, if you don't control your diabetes, you are likely to have 3 to 5 times more cardiovascular problems. And he says, okay doctor, from tomorrow I'll control my sugar. But the patient asked me, but then once I control my sugar from tomorrow only, then my chances of having MI will come back to as per normal population? So you say, no, it will not come down immediately. So normal level of having MI will come again after 10 years. That means even if a person start controlling sugar from immediate effect, body remembers what has been done to the body. So legacy effect is the body remembers for almost same time of period for which the sugar has been uncontrolled. So friends, you can remember like this, legacy effect is concerned with cardiovascular mortality in diabetes. This is the box number 16. Legacy effect. Okay? Legacy effect. Now we talk about some more new things. We got one drug, telmisartan. It's a ARB, known to all of you. But a new thing has, and this name is not, this point is not given in 19th edition also. But this point is discussed in all the conferences. Telmisartan is the one drug which acts also act on the PAR gamma receptors. And all of us know that glitazone act on the PPAR gamma receptor. The only ARB which is acting against the, which is effective against the, which also act in the PPAR gamma receptor is telmisartan, not given in Harrison 19th edition also. This is telmisartan. Box number, I think it is 17. Well, now one more thing has come up. Role of BP control. Role of BP control in diabetes. Let's learn the sub. This you need to understand very clearly. Suppose there's one patient whose sugar is very high, his BP is also very high, and he goes to one diabetologist. He reduces his sugar only, doesn't reduce the BP. His complication will come down this much. We got another patient whose sugar is very high, BP very high, and he goes to a cardiologist. He reduces BP, doesn't reduce sugar, sugar remains high, but his diabetic complication, they come down drastically, especially macrovascular complication. So the new concept says in diabetic patient, not only you have to control the sugar, BP has should be also controlled. Now the new guidelines as per 19th edition, they are as follows. So they are as follows. So what they say that in diabetic, BP should be below 140, below 90. But in young, diabetic patient, it should be below 130 and below 80. Below 130 and below 80. This is the 19th edition update. 19th edition new guidelines are 140, 90, and 130, 80 in younger diabetic patient. Well, the drug of choice for diabetes is always diabetes. With hypertension is always ACEI. Drug of choice is ACEI because the reason being that not only it will control the hypertension, but it will also help in the, it reduces the ACEI, not only will control the BP, but also reduces progression of nephropathy. So drug of choice is ACEI. Okay, now one more drug has come in the Indian market as a tablet, but new drug recently launched, not given in 19th edition of Harrison also. This is beyond 19th edition, Siroglitazar. Siroglitazar. If not visible, I can write again. Siroglitazar. This is a tablet available in Indian market. As I told you, not given in 19th edition. This question will pakka come to you in this exam because widely discussed in all the conferences. What is the special thing? It acts on the PPAR alpha as well as and gamma receptors. So it's one thing act on the PPAR alpha and gamma receptors. So it reduces sugar as well as lipid. So they are beyond, this is beyond 19th edition. This is the box number 20. Okay. We got one more drug, that is bevacizumab. These are the two drugs. This is not given in the chapter of in the most of books also. Recent updates. These drugs have been used in the treatment of diabetic retinopathy. In fact, regarding Ranibizumab, a big trial was done in AIIMS recently for the treatment of diabetic retinopathy. And the trial went a grand success. Since it was a big trial in AIIMS, it's quite possible is that this question might come in your AIIMS exam. Quite possible. Okay? Recent updates. So we use these drugs. All our new drugs, we use the treatment of diabetic retinopathy. Recent drugs. This is box number 21. Now, a very frequently asked question, and most of you do commit mistake on that question. If I asked you one question, which is the earliest manifestation of diabetic nephropathy? I'm quite sure because all of you have read routine guides and they give answer as microalbuminuria. That is the most common wrong answer. The earliest manifestation is diabetic nephropathy. Nephropathy is raised GFR. Is box number 22. And one more new drug for the treatment of painful diabetic neuropathy is duloxetine. It's a new drug for painful diabetic neuropathy. Okay, so this all about the new thing in diabetes. I hope I have given you lot of new drugs and many new drugs which are not given in 19th edition of Harrison also, right? So now I briefly I'll tell you what you know. Now the exam system is Prometric system. What is Prometric system? How the number of is evaluated? That we'll discuss in the next lecture number 2. So this is the end of lecture number 1. So as I told you, I'll be taking series of small lectures, and if you go through all these lectures, you are bound to get a lot of new questions. And in the next lecture, I'll discuss Prometric system also. I hope you learned a lot. Thank you very much, and now look for the lecture number 2. Thank you very much.